Luckily, the rain did stop for a second. So we have some last minute contingency. If by any chance the thunderstorm starts again and we lose power, please just remain seated. David will pull down the black curtains. Those are plastic, and we'll allow light back before we move, because without electricity, we're kind of at a loss. All our equipment is electric, the lighting's electric, but hopefully that won't happen, just for emergency. Also, a few more announcements. There's no personal videotaping. Videos of the show are available out front. Please, you can take photos, but not flash. No flash photography. It's very distracting, and you know, people can trip, they can fall. It's dangerous to the actors, and we want them to do a great job. And they were phenomenal last night, and I know they are going to give it their all today. I'm sorry about the heat. One of those things we don't have control over. Tomorrow's going to be really great, though. Okay. Trying to think. A couple of announcements. The role of Fluffy the cat is being played by Colleen the cat. And one name, there's always one, got left off the program, and that is Meg Loughran. She's doing a number of different roles, so I wanted to announce that. Hope you enjoy the show. Thank you.
even own the church.
Amen.
To a false shop and a company clapping stores. Save and travel through gay and petty. While you can go barefoot. But I'm here today to help you imagine a better day and bring it to pass. I'm here to help you say, no more!
No more!
But I cannot do it alone. I need your help. If you care about your men and your families, you get off your knees and fight. But you are too cowardly to fight. I will fight for you. Lord knows, I am a woman who is not afraid of the bloodhounds.
Just tell me what to do, I ain't afraid to fight.
Then you're our leader. Take that pan with you, you got with you. And when you see the foreman coming up the hill with his scabs and his mules, begin to bang away like holy hell.
Ain't no scab gonna take my man's
job. Get ready to march, ladies.
Let us pray for God's help.
I quit praying a long time ago and took to swearing. When I pray, I'll have to wait till I'm dead to get anything. But when I swear, I get things here.
Day I die.
John J. Jackson of the United States District Court. Will not tolerate any disrespect for the law or this court. Now you people will contain yourself or you will be ejected. Proceed.
Your Honor, we are here to try Mrs. Mary Harris Jones on the charges of violating a court injunction, inciting to riot, and trespassing.
I would just like to say that I consider union organizers to be bad cops. That leading patent of the honest labor of coal mines. They are nothing but busybodies creating dissatisfaction amongst the class of people that are quite well disposed, and who do not wish to be disturbed by their unceasing agitation.
Macho ain't no bad cop!
Remove that woman. Now, Miss Jones, what do you have to say?
These people are my family. And while they're breaking their backs serving humanity, they're serving them for the money power.
You're not going to
You are in contempt of this court, Miss Jones.
You bet I am.
And you insult this court.
How dare the federal government send a stance judgment on me?
Miss Jones, please contain yourself. Now, it seems to me that it would be wiser for you to come to attack the almighty being who has intended your sex to be sued. There are many charity organizations which would welcome your assistance.
Judge, if I had my way, I would tear down every charity institution in the country today and build upon their ruins the Temple of Justice.
Seems that the charges against you are well-founded, Miss Jones. I find it hard to believe that a woman of your age and intelligence could allow herself to be used as an instrument of agitation.
I saw my duty, and I did it, and I do it again. I'm not afraid of jail, Judge. I'm not afraid to speak my mind, either. It's good that you live a long life. When all this is over, I hope we become good friends and one day meet in heaven.
And Miss Jones, I hope one day you come to your senses. Bail if you may remove Miss Jones to jail.
Law
law and order.
When a woman on the border of insanity is free to promulgate her vanity.
An arrogant debater.
A ruthless agitator.
Out of state intruder.
A gopher broke deluder.
She invades our mountain passes and infuses all the masses with a spirit of rebellion. The woman is a heading, so you see. I dare not set her free.
Whatever happened to freedom of speech? Is it only for those who are out beyond reach? Does it stop on the day when it gets in the way of power and those with the money to pay? For laws that will make sure that things go their way? I think this story has legs.
Call a bailiff! I can't have that woman forced her way to my jail!
Love.
Good morning, Miss Jones. Miss Jones, you're a free woman.
Free so soon? How did that happen?
I don't know. I'm just following orders. Judge says, set Miss Jones free, and that's what I'm doing.
Well, I'm glad the judge came to his senses. Good morning, ladies. Sleep well.
Mother Jones, now that you're free, what are you going to do?
Keep up the fight, of course.
What about the injunction?
You can't walk in West Virginia without stepping on an injunction.
Telegram for Mrs. Jones.
That's her over there.
Are you Mrs. Mary Harris Jones?
Oh, he's my young son.
Telegram.
Thank you.
What's it say, Mother Jones?
It's from John Mitchell, president of the United Mine Workers. It says Pennsylvania needs me.
Will the strike continue without you?
You predict violence?
Oh, why are you asking me? It's the operative part of the bold and self-doubt.
If the fight is so important here, then why are you leaving for Pennsylvania?
The children of Pennsylvania are being abused at the hands of the mill owners. They haven't the will or the strength to fight for themselves. They need me to fight for them.
What about the miners? Don't they need you too?
The miners of West Virginia have proven their courage. Their families are behind them 100%. But things go wrong here. I'll be back.
Find something interesting about that paper anyway.
right on the front page.
Oh, here we go again. I don't know what you find so fascinating about some old lady marching around with a bunch of West Virginia miners.
She's only the greatest female organizer in the country.
That's all.
You'd be better off thinking about how you're going to fix your hair tonight. Jack's going to be there with a friend.
Listen to this. This is the time of Mother Jones. Her appearance is a signal for those who grow rich by grinding in the faces of the poor to go slow. And if they disregard the warning, so much the worse for them and the better for organized labor.
That's swell, Jenny.
You don't listen to what she says about the owner's wives. The pampered wives with $5 worth of paint on their faces.
That's even more than you, Mary Jo.
Hush up, John Stevens.
And they have toothbrushes and feather pillows for their poodle dogs. While the children of the poor slave 12 and 14 hour days in dangerous factories.
Toothbrushes in their dogs?
I don't care about all that stuff. I'm gonna find me a rich beau and get myself out of this place.
Well, what about Jack?
Jack's sweet and all.
But I'm just practicing on him.
Mary Jo, shame on you!
I can be truthful with my best friend, Tana.
Yes, but...
I'll leave it to you to be noble, Jenny. I'd rather be rich.
If I could make a choice about the life I'd like to live, I'd make it in a flash, and here's the answer I would give. I'd rather be rich with money to spare than to waste my life in bed. I could easily sleep all day, then stay all night in my mansion by the sea, where there's only him and me and a dozen servants I can order about.
Sitting on their big fat feather pillow.
My free. I get to see Mother Jones in person. Maggie? Maggie? Do you want to come with us? Hey, Jenny. I won't be able to keep my eyes open. I'm just too tired.
Too tired for what?
None of your bees, Maggie.
You know, Mary Jo, maybe it's considered okay for you Catholics, but Pastor Beecham says it's a sin for all women to wear makeup.
How unfortunate for you.
Pastor Beecham also gave me an article for you to read, Jenny.
How thoughtful.
He saw how you idolized that horrible Mother Jones, and he thought it's about time you knew the truth about that woman.
What are you saying, Nancy?
I'm not saying anything. I will just read you what the article says, and I quote, "The woman called Mother Jones is a vulgar, heartless, vicious creature with a fiery temper and a cold-blooded brutality, rare even in slums."
That's a wicked lie!
Oh, no, it's not, and she even ran a bribe with Denver!
You're
what's going on in here? There's no fighting in Dumpy Rock.
She attacked me, Mr. Gander, and she's a socialist, too!
Appeal to reason. I don't like to see this kind of trash on company property. I'm sending you home for the day, Miss Martin. The next time this happens, you'll be fired!
But Nancy, stop, man!
Watch your mouth, Miss. You'll be next. Lunch is over. Back to work. Jack Dorsey.
Yep.
Jack Carry the boy home. Next time, young man, be more careful. These kinds of accidents hold up production. The machines aren't running. We can't make a living.
Yes, sir. I'll be more careful, sir.
Meeting, Mrs. Stevens. Our eyes are
surprised that you get involved with all this radical nonsense. Finally, you feel like yourself and your family.
Speak plain, Mr. Gander.
Just a little warning. I sent your niece home today for bringing socialist propaganda onto country property.
It's a free country.
See that it doesn't happen again.
And it's got a mind for all.
Still, I'd hate to see that headstrong girl jeopardizing your livelihood.
Thank you for your concern. Good night. Oh, Mr. Gander, will you be at the prayer meeting tonight? Pastor Beecham told me to remind you.
Thank you, Miss Whitman.
We will be praying for all the drunks.
I beg your pardon?
Pastor Beecham says that alcohol is of all evil in this country.
An interesting idea, if you'll excuse me.
He said demon rum was the cause of the last depression. People were too tired to work, so they didn't have any money, and then they spent it all on alcohol, and then they starved.
gobbledygook's your bench.
What?
Who do you think is coming? Are you crazy, Mother Jones?
You're kidding. I didn't know.
Well, now you know.
Don't drop that.
Jack, they need this.
Jack, those benches are too close together. So.
Oh, Jack! Jack!
Mary Jo, you made it!
I told you we would. How do you like my new hat?
It's very becoming.
Thank you. Now, where's this friend of yours?
That's him. Over there.
You have to introduce him to Jenny.
I have to. Please, Rob.
Now, Jack, once the meeting stops, we won't be able to talk.
Okay.
No, Mary Jo.
Thomas! Over here.
What is it, Jack?
There's someone I want you to meet. Mary Jo Sanders and his friend Jenny. They work at Kensington Mill.
Kensington Mill? How come you haven't joined the strike yet?
If I had my way, I would have started it.
A real firebrand, eh?
Stand up for what I believe in.
How about if I speak to Mr. Gottlieb about making you an organizer?
Would you really?
We need someone over here. Someone who's willing to stir things up.
I'll work real hard, I promise.
Thomas! Oh, speaking of work, nice to meet you, Miss Marco. Miss Sanders. Come on, Jack.
Did you hear that, Mary Jo? I'm gonna be an organizer.
What a fine figure of a man. And Jenna, I do believe you took a shot.
Wait till I tell Mikey, he'll be so proud.
Jenna, you ain't listening to me.
Oh, I'm sorry, Mary Jo. What did you say?
What did you think of Thomas?
Thomas? He seems very dedicated.
I mean, as a man.
Oh, well, I'm sure he's a very hard worker. But let's go find a seat. We'll have to stand. Oh, look.
Hi,
how are you?
Quiet! Quiet down, please! You all take your seats.
Thomas was more than that.
Welcome to all Union brothers and honored guests alike. Tonight, we are here to commemorate the fallen martyrs of the 1877 massacre. Too often, it is easy to forget those who have come before us. But the battle is not won.
No!
No.
We are fighting for human dignity.
Yes!
If you let yourself be treated as a slave, you not only dishonor yourselves, you dishonor those who have come before you. Hell no! Let us show those in the realms of heaven that we are worthy.
Yes!
Let us show them that they are gone, but not forgotten.
Not forgotten!
They are gone, but not. I'm
their presence, words and songs of praise, then dishonor them by our cowardly behavior. As I arrived today, through the fields of West Virginia, I sat in the union office. One child after another came to the door with a sad story of abuse at the hands of the mill owners. They're with me tonight. Boys, stand up. Let's give these boys a hand for their remarkable courage. They have been maimed in the factories of the rich, with no compensation for their deformities, forced to beg for a living. And what does the company say? Accidents happen. Children are careless. I ask you, are we so careless that to stand by and watch this abuse continue?
No!
Then will we care?
No!
I say, we must stand together and fight for our rights.
Strike!
There you have it. There's the answer.
Strike! 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 Strike!
Quiet! Quiet down, please! Then it's agreed. Tomorrow you will join our strike. And we will not go back until they meet our demands. Please notify those who are in sympathy but could not be here tonight.
The Martins of 1877 watch us tonight with pride.
They are gone, but not forgotten. For the sacrifice they made.
For the cause of human dignity.
I spoke to Golly. He says the job's yours.
I won't let you down.
Well, see you tomorrow. We've got work.
Mary Jo, you stop at the stones and let them know about the strike. All by myself.
I'll walk you home here together.
Thank you, Jack. But aren't we being a little hasty? We've waited long enough. Are you with us or not? Well, of course I'm with you, Jack.
Then hurry up. I've got to tell the Wilsons and the Jacobsons.
Mikey!
Yes, sis?
You go make sure the Thompsons know.
Excuse me, one more thing. Meet here tomorrow at 9 a.m. to arrange for the picket lines.
Thank you. Good night.
Your fault. We can't do the work with only 15 people.
It's the striker's fault. Get out of here. All of you.
You can strike us down. We'll go to City Hall.
Jack, get everyone together. Tell them we're marching to City Hall. Tell them to keep calm.
Yes.
What's going on? What's happened here?
My friend was just killed in the factory. She was only 11.
We're going on strike, Miss Smith. And we're taking our grievance to City Hall. This sort of is the last straw. Time to raise a little hell.
What if they won't listen to you?
And we'll take off and play to the president. No more child labor. When I meet St. Peter, got a tale to tell. But if you're in debt from the cops, the story free when you hear that duck to save that duck. That's a race to the hell.
Race to the hell, the heavens here, but race to the hell, to the owners here. Race to the hell, to the nation here, so skeletons have a role. Here's the race to the hell.
Men and men about to make us free, they be rolling in a race to make us open, you see. Women and children in slavery, not what the truth is supposed to be.
father was at my house when we went over to look for him.
God, finally. She blames herself for Maggie's death.
Yeah.
everybody. I know they all hate me.
No one hates you, Mary Jo. The best thing for you to do right now is to join us on the march.
Why?
We're marching to Long Island to see President Roosevelt.
Why?
So we can pass a law against child labor.
Can you do that?
He's the
president. When do we leave?
Right now. So you'd better get some things together.
I'm with you, Jenny. And I've changed. You'll see.
Abolish child labor, forgive the owners of the slave. We're pursuing happiness and
here once.
Nonsense, George. We're on a mission and we're gonna help these poor children.
It's too dangerous, Mrs. Kelly. There's a bunch of radicals trying to march into town.
No place for the Lady Hate Society.
Why, Harry Smith, I never thought I'd see the day when my own husband would be persecuting young children in the name of the law. What is this country coming to?
What?
It's a disgrace. Why, my Ralph would never say this, son.
Mrs. Blythe, that you? Turn around and go home at once.
Over my dead body.
These people are not allowed to enter the city.
Fine, who is one of them?
That's the spirit, Mrs. Blythe. Come along, ladies.
Step right up, good people of Bristol. Listen to our woeful tale. We only ask for human rights. That is why you go to jail.
It's our workers, union children of the factory. Where many lives are brought to ruin. Now we strike for victory.
The difficulty of the march, I think his complaint is petty. Don't
Columbia hospitality. It'll be wonderful for the children to get a good night's sleep.
Everyone is saying no, because more candy stands up for what's right. Girls, bring these good people whatever they want on the house.
Ain't she the soft touch all of a sudden?
I'll have a special of the day.
She's putting on a good show for you, Mother Jones.
Some of the past treats us. We get fixed, Will, and she's giving you the special of the day.
Mrs. Morton Hanley, friend of the waking class.
Is this Mrs. Hanley trying to use us to improve her image?
It's cheaper for her to give you free lodgings for a night and look like a saint.
That way, nobody will leave us when we complain about it.
That Mrs. Hanley's a shrew.
What's your grievance, girls?
She's got us under a contract that makes us bite to old slaves.
We're forced to sleep in a cellar full of ointment.
And she makes the food she made from the customers' leftovers.
That's outrageous. New girl needs organized.
We're ready whenever you say.
Unfair working conditions. No more slave labor.
Unfair working conditions. No more slave labor. Unfair working conditions. No more slave labor.
This is how you repay my hospitality? Get out. Get out, all of you.
Understand you've been following us.
For your own safety, ma'am.
And why would you be concerned?
concerned about my safety.
I think it'd be best for you and the children not to continue on to Oyster Bay.
The president will not see you.
You'll only embarrass yourself and your cause.
If he rejects us, he'll only be embarrassing himself.
Please be reasonable.
I represent the Philadelphia textile workers. It is reasonable for me to expect the president to see us.
Have it your own way.
Mother Jones, I'm afraid we have no choice but to turn back.
Not you too.
I have no choice.
Mr. Gough, you set out to accomplish something. And I'm not turning back till we do.
Well, if you won't change your mind, then I'll leave without you. And I'm rescinding my office's support.
Go if you must.
Damn you, woman, you'll destroy us!
If I gave up every time I ran into a stone wall, I wouldn't get anywhere.
I! That's the problem, you're only thinking of yourself.
How can you say such a thing? I would have my life for working for injustice.
You're letting your vanity get in the way. This is about the union, not you.
To hell with it, go. We'll carry on without you.
Good luck. You'll need it. Thomas!
In a minute, Mr. Gottlieb.
You're not going too, are you?
I don't know what to do.
We've come so far. I'm not turning back. Can't you talk to him, try and change his mind?
I'll see what I can do, but it seems pretty determined to go. I don't like to deal with it.
I'll be okay. I'll meet you back at headquarters.
Stuck at the crossroads, which way to turn? Looks like we still have some lessons to learn. Should we step forward into the unknown? That's a decision we all make. Standing before a map of our fate, choose a direction before it's too late. Has a battle been lost or can it be won? Will we be plagued by things left undone?
an old Hillary like me.
Do you think President Roosevelt will see us?
No. I don't think we all should go. Just a few children, no more than seven.
That way, we can save the poor from the riots.
I'll take care of it.
Mother Jones?
Yes, Miss.
Will you be taking the train to Long Island tomorrow?
Yes, I'll be taking a few marches with me. No more than seven, so we've got to offend with Terry Barnes. Only seven people, they can't save a storm in the President's castle.
What will you do if he refuses to see you?
What can I do? I just don't believe he would reject us after we've come so far.
All reports say the odds are against you.
I've beaten the odds before.
Well, good luck to you, then.
Every so often, I'm beating the odds. I'm putting my fate in the hands of the gods. Though they've let me down many a time, I'm still moving forward, a step up in time. Time for me is running low. My strength is weakening with every blow. Where did that younger part of me go?
Thomas, how can you talk about making a difference and then expect me to abandon all I
going to fail. The president won't see her. How many times do you need to hear it?
I don't care if he won't see us. The principle that counts.
Standing on principle won't get you anywhere today.
Standing on principle is all there is for me.
If you stay, Gottlieb will probably fire you. Things will be difficult for us.
If I don't stay, I couldn't live with myself.
Good luck.
Thomas, it's not just Mother Jones. Doing this for Maggie Stone.
I understand.
See you when I get back?
I'll be waiting.
Thomas is leaving. Mr. Gottlieb insisted.
We're ready.
Where's Mother Jones?
She's coming.
Mr. Bay, here we come.
Children.
I believe.